Good morning to all. Prime Minister Virata and the Secretary Rose Marie Ebellion of the National Economic and Development Authority, distinguished guests and speakers, representatives from the academe, government, civil society, private sector, and the media, and my fellow civil servants, welcome to you all to the third annual public policy conference of the PIDS. On behalf of the PIDS, I welcome you to this conference, the culminating activity of the 15th Development Policy Research Month. It's a privilege for our institution to host today's conference on federalism perspectives, and I wish to thank each one of our esteemed scholars and experts, and of course all of you, for honoring our invitation to join us in this particular event. I'm glad to inform you that this is already the third year that the PIDS has been organizing this public policy conference. In September 2015, the very first conference, we launched this conference, and the discussion centered on the broad theme of harnessing our institutions and human capital for inclusive growth. It emphasized the important role these two elements play in the development process and the reforms needed in our education and governance systems to make economic growth both inclusive and sustainable. In that conference, we had Professor Emeritus National Scientist Raul Favella and also Professor Emeritus Dante Canlas as main speakers. Meanwhile, in the second APPC last year, we highlighted the need to build resilient systems in the Philippines. The said event brought together policy experts and scholars from various fields of study to provide us with a deeper understanding of the complex risk landscape confronting the country and the need to develop a comprehensive approach in building resilient systems in all fronts. For this year, with the theme Critical Perspectives on Federalism for Regional Development, the APPC will focus on the major issues surrounding the proposed shift to a federal form of government and also discuss our wide-ranging experiences in decentralization. As we know, since the Spanish colonial period, Manila has served as the country's seat of economic and political power. Now, some of us, especially those living in the Visayas and Mindanao, have blamed such concentration of power as the main driver of the uneven development in the country. Not all of you may agree, but that is a significant part of today's conversations. And they have called, therefore, for a more even sharing of power, resources, and governmental responsibilities. Studies have pointed out that the passage of the Local Government Code in 1991, which aimed to diffuse this concentration of power in the capital, despite this passage, the passage of this law, it seems that genuine decentralization and autonomy have not been fully realized. In fact, several PIDS studies and also studies by other scholars reveal that local governments continue to face various challenges in their exercise of functions and responsibilities assigned to them by the Local Government Code of 1991. A significant factor behind the mixed performance of LGUs has precisely been the imbalance in resource generation capacities between the national government and the local governments. As a response, there has been a renewed and stronger call for a shift to federalism that has been laid down before the Filipino people by the highest leadership of the land. Those who support a federalist structure of government maintains that it is the best way to address deeply rooted political and economic problems, especially poverty and the separatist movement in the countryside. A very important challenge before us in the poly research and academic community is to clarify the policy discourse on federalism. As we will learn from today's presentations and discussions during the open forum, there's not only one model of federalism that countries with a federal structure of government have followed. There are many issues to be discussed. The federal states that we know of today have agreed to adopt a particular federalist structure that they believe would address their development challenges. In this regard, the PIDS third annual public policy conference endeavors to contribute to an intelligent and informed policy discourse on federalism. There is a need to undertake a substantial analytical work, a thorough review, and wide-ranging discussions on the country's experiences with decentralization, and examine whether federalism is indeed a far better, far superior political structure to address the many social, political, and economic problems that ail Philippine society. Some of us do believe that reforming or overhauling drastically the local government code of 1991 would be a better way, pathway towards the goal envisioned by society. So there's this big debate within those who believe that what we need is a radical overhaul of the local government code, and those who think that we should shift to a federal form of government. Many reasons behind this, and we hopefully would be able to surface this as we discuss and exchange views on the presentations. Thus, today's presentations and discussions will cover key issues on the political feasibility of the proposed shift to federalism, the form and fiscal design of a federal government in the Philippine setting, as well as various implications of federalism given the country's political, economic, social, and historical context. Hopefully, the results of today's conference can help enlighten the policy discourse on federalism, which will help the public and policymakers to make an informed decision in the near future. I encourage everyone to have an open and critical mind as we listen to the presentations and to participate actively in the open forum. Thank you for your presence today and your invaluable participation. Good morning.